UCI devices are calibrated on standard steel. Testing the hardness apart from steel requires a so-called adjustment. Why this is needed and how to apply this and more, you will find out now. The calibration of a SONODUR probe is generated with standard steel plates on different hardness levels. In addition, the frequency of each steel plate will be recorded. Both values will be stored into the probe electronics. Now that we know the specific hardness value of each hardness block and the corresponding frequency, it is possible to create a calibration curve within a certain hardness range. This curve will be used to translate the so-called frequency shift of a UCI probe to a certain hardness value for standard steel. Standard steel has an E modulus of about 205 to 210 GPa. This means that a standard SONODUR UCI probe is calibrated for the use of standard steel. If the measurement of steels or alloys with a different E modulus is required, a so-called adjustment must be carried out. Why is that? Every mobile hardness testing device is affected by the E modulus of steel or alloy. Only classical hardness testers and testing machines for fatigue testing are independent of the E modulus due to its design. What happens during an adjustment in theory? Due to different E modulus, every material has its own individual material curve. A material curve describes the hardness as a function of the frequency shift. So, for example, if aluminum should be measured with a UCI device, it is necessary to adjust or else translate the calibrated steel material curve into an aluminum curve. The E modulus of aluminum is 70 GPa, which is a lot less compared to standard steel with 205 to 210 GPa. This results in a much softer acoustic coupling between the indenter and the material. This material property has to be compensated, otherwise the measurement value would be calculated too high. The so-called adjustment number tells the system to shift the actual measurement value to the deviating material properties. Surface quality is of paramount importance depending on the test load. It is mandatory to minimize the surface influence by mild grinding. Perform 5 measurements at an appropriate location on the reground surface area. Double check for a homogeneous distribution of the measurement values. When there are outliers detected, exclude them from the measurement and repeat the measurement until there are 5 stable and reliable readings. Take these readings and go to the adjustment settings. Use these readings for adjustment. Input the new reference value according to the desired material hardness. Whenever possible, use a reliable value from a classical hardness tester as a reference value to ensure perfect conditions. The input box of the calibration field will appear in yellow color. This means the adjustment is active. It is now possible to perform the measurement with the corrected settings for e.g. aluminum. In this video, we used the SONODUR 3 device to carry out an adjustment. If you liked the video, please subscribe to our channel.